How much would you need to deposit in an account now in order to have $3,000 in the account in 5 years? Assume the account earns 3% interest compounded monthly. We'll be using the compounded interest formula to solve this problem. If we take a look at these two formulas here below, they are equivalent but use different variables to represent the same quantities. This first formula is probably a more common compounded interest formula, but our textbook does use this form of the equation here, where the account balance after a certain amount of time in this formula is A, in this formula it's P sub n. P in this formula and P sub 0 in this formula represent the starting amount or the present value. R is the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal in both formulas. In this first formula, n is the number of compounds per year. Notice how n occurs here and here. In our second formula, k is the number of compounds per year, which occurs here and here. And then finally, in this first formula, lowercase t is time in years. And in the second formula, capital N is time in years. To be consistent with our text, let's go ahead and use this formula here. Because we want $3,000 in the account in 5 years, P sub capital N would be P sub 5, which is equal to $3,000. Capital N, the number of years, is equal to 5. The interest is 3%, so R is equal to 3%. As a decimal, this would be 0.03. Since the interest is compounded monthly, K, the number of compounds, is equal to 12. We want to find the initial deposit of the present value, which would be P sub 0. So now to set up our equation, we'd have P sub 5, or 3,000, equals P sub 0, which we're trying to find, times the quantity 1 plus R divided by K. That would be 0.03 divided by 12 raised to the power of N times K, which would be 5 times 12. Notice how here we're dividing by 12 to get a monthly interest rate, and here we're multiplying the number of years times 12 to get the total number of months. 5 times 12 would be 60, so we have 3,000 equals P sub 0 times the quantity 1 plus 0.03 divided by 12 raised to the power of 60. We want to solve this equation for P sub 0. We do have to be careful about rounding errors when solving equations like this. What we don't want to do is get a decimal approximation for this sum and then raise it to the 60th power, because it would produce a rounding error. Let's go ahead and leave it in this form and solve for P sub 0 by dividing both sides of the equation by the sum raised to the 60th power. Notice on the right side, this would simplify to 1. So we have P sub 0 is equal to this quotient here, which will round to the nearest cent. So now we'll go to the calculator, and we have 3,000 divided by the quantity 1 plus 0.03 divided by 12, close parenthesis, raised to the 60th power. But into the nearest cent, we would have $2,582.61. This is the amount that would have to be deposited today to have $3,000 in the account in 5 years if the account earns 3% interest compounded monthly. This can also be considered the present value of this $3,000 5 years into the future. I hope you found this helpful.